Alright, so in this video, we'll be talking about raceways and conduits. Okay, so we have here raceways and conduits. So, the objectives for this video, after this video, we can differentiate between raceway and conduit. And we'll also identify the different types of raceways. Okay, so according to Article 1.0.1 of the Philippine Electrical Code, that states that a raceway is an enclosed channel of metal or non-metallic materials designed expressly for holding wires, cables, or bus bars with additional functions as permitted by this code. Raceway include but not limited or but are not limited to rigid metal conduit, rigid non-metallic conduit, intermediate metal conduit, liquid tight flexible conduit, flexible metallic tubing, flexible metal conduit, electrical metallic tubing, and electrical non-metallic tubing, underfloor raceways, cellular concrete floor raceways, cellular metal floor raceways, surface raceways, wireways, and busways. So according to the Philippine Electrical Code, a raceway is any enclosed channel of metal or non-metallic materials which is designed to hold, so to hold wires, cables, or bus bars, or basically conductors with additional functions as permitted by this code, either to support or also to protect the wires from damage or deterioration. An electrical conduit is a raceway which is a piping system used for protection and routing of electrical wiring. Electrical conduit may be made of metal, plastic, fiber, and clay. So an electrical conduit is a raceway, but its main difference from the conventional raceway is that it is a piping system, or it is a pipe, or it has a round diameter. So that's why it is called a conduit. It can be made up of metal, plastic, fiber, or clay. So this is an example of a conduit, and this is an example of a raceway, another type of raceway, which is a cable tray. Now we'll go to the types of raceway. So commonly used raceways are busways, cable trays, wireways, surface raceways, and floor raceways. Conduits are also types of raceways. So the first one is a busway. So Article 3.68.1.2 of the Philippine Electrical Code states that busways are grounded metal enclosure containing factory-mounted, bare, or insulated conductors, which are usually copper or aluminum bars, rods, or tubes. They are usually used in exposed and concealed wiring or through walls and floors. So their main advantage is that they are easy to install, especially for vertical wiring of the main feeders. So a busway is a grounded metal enclosure, so containing factory mounted. So when you say factory mounted, it is mounted on the factory or in the manufacturing phase itself. No, what is mounted on the factory is the bare or insulated conductors, either copper or aluminum bars, rods, or tube. So its main advantage is this type of raceway is easy to install, especially if you are going to have a vertical wiring for those high-rise building, for the main feeder, so for the main feeder conductor. Okay, so this is an assembly of a busway. So these are the components of a busway. So we have here the feeders, we have the flange end, we have the elbows, so this is a double elbow, and we have the power box or the circuit breaker box, which is usually attached to the feeder. Okay, so this is a complete run of a busway or a bus stock system. So this is the switchboard, this is the main, the main circuit board or the main distribution board of a certain high-rise building. We have here the flange end connection, a vertical and a horizontal feeders supported. If that is a vertical feeder, that is supported by a vertical spring support. Then we have the elbow, double elbow, if you are going to change, to change the run. Then we have the, again, a horizontal, and we have the box here. So sometimes the box will also have here its own wiring, or it is sometimes used to reduce or to enlarge, no, the feeder bus duct. We have the horizontal hanger, which is support and elbow. We have here the T section, no? This is the T end of the bus duct, no? In which we could have here two separate direction. Then we have the plug-in, so or the circuit box or the circuit breaker box, in which this is the place where you will put your enclosed circuit breaker on your floor, no, floor distribution panel. Okay, then we will go to cable trays. So Article 3.92.1.2 of the Philippine Electrical Code states that a cable tray is a unit or assembly of units or sections and associated fittings forming a structural system used to securely fasten or support cables and raceways. Cable trays shall be permitted to be used as support system for service conductors, feeders, branch circuits, communication circuits, control circuits, and signaling circuits. So a cable tray is a unit of or assembly of a unit. It could be single or an assembly of units, no, or sections, no, with associated fittings. So they are usually used to securely fasten or support cables and also other raceways. Okay, so we have here the three common types of cable trays. So this is the somewhat common, no? Common appearance of a cable tray. Then we have also a cable ladder, which is also considered as a cable tray, and a cable trunking, no? Then we have wireways. So wireways are classified into two different types. We have the metal and non-metallic, no, wireways. So Article 3.76.1.2 of the Philippine Electrical Code states that metal wireways are sheet of metal troughs with hinge or removable covers for housing and protecting electric wires and cables, and in which conductors are laid in place after the wireways or after the wireway has been installed as a complete system. So a metallic wireway, so its main material is metal, so it is shaped like a metal trough with hinge or removable covers, used to house and protect conductors, no? So it is usually installed as a complete system. Then we have also the Article 3.78.1.2 of the Philippine Electrical Code states also that non-metallic wireways are flame retardant, non-metallic trough with removable covers for housing and protecting electric wires and cables, in which conductors are laid in place after the wireway has been installed as a complete system. So a non-metallic wireway is a flame retardant, so meaning it will not allow flame, no, to grow, no, once it is heated, or that's why it's called flame retardant. And it's non-metallic trough, or also it has a removable cover. And it, and same with the metallic wireway, it is used to house and protect electric wires and cables. So metal wireways are used in exposed and concealed wiring, while non-metallic wireways are used in exposed wiring only and in corrosive location as determined by the manufacturer. So the metal wireways are used in exposed and concealed, while for non-metallic, it is used for exposed wiring only, and also if we are going to have an exposed wiring on corrosive location. Because if we are going to use metal wireways in corrosive location, it will cause the metal to rust, no? Okay, so we have here, this is an appearance of a metallic wireway, and this is for the non-metallic wireway. Okay, then we will have surface raceway. So this raceway is also known as the wire molding. Then there are two types of surface raceways. We have metal and non-metallic surface raceways. So Article 3.86.1.2 of the Philippine Electrical Code defines a surface metal raceway. It states that a surface metal raceway is a metallic raceway that is intended to be mounted to the surface of a structure with associated couplings, connectors, boxes, and fittings for the installation of electrical conductors. They are usually used for dry locations and hazardous locations permitted by the code. No? So that is the, that is for metal raceway, no? So surface metal raceway. So they are intended, no, to be mounted on the surface of the structure. And they are usually used in dry locations and hazardous locations. The surface non-metallic raceway is defined by Article 3.88.1.2 as a non-metallic raceway that is intended to be mounted to the surface of the structure with associated couplings, connectors, boxes, and fittings for the isolation of electrical conductors. So its application is limited to dry locations. So a surface non-metallic raceway, its application is only for dry location. So we have here the, this is the surface metallic raceway, and this is the surface non-metallic raceway. Okay, so this is for dry and hazardous location. This is only for dry locations. Okay, next we have floor raceway. So commonly used floor raceways are underfloor raceways, cellular concrete floor raceways, and cellular floor raceways. So Article 3.90.1.2 states that underfloor raceway shall be permitted beneath the surface of the concrete or other flooring material or in office occupancies where laid flush with the concrete floor and covered with linoleum or equivalent floor covering. These raceways are installed below the floors and are made to protect wires from damage caused by moisture or excessive heat under the floor slab. So the main reason why we use underfloor raceways is to protect our conductors from moisture or excessive heat if you are going to put that one on our floor slabs. Then cellular floor raceway are electrical wiring ducts or cells from steel floor deck that serves as a structural formwork for placement of the concrete slabs and also as wire and cable raceway within the concrete floor slab. These raceways are classified into two. We have the cellular concrete floor raceway and the cellular metal floor raceway. So a cellular concrete floor raceway is described in Article 3.72 of the Philippine Electrical Code. This raceway provides a complete underfloor electrical distribution system. For this system, the floor is constructed of a precast reinforced concrete member. This raceway is divided into two parts, the header and the cell. So, as defined by the code, a header is a transverse metal raceway for electric conductor providing access to the to predetermined cells of precast cellular concrete floor, thereby permitting the isolation of the electrical conductors from a distribution center to the floor cell, and a cell as a single enclosed tubular space in floor made of precast cellular concrete slabs, at the direction of the cell being parallel to the direction of the floor member. This raceway cannot be used in corrosive environment and in commercial garages. So the cellular concrete floor raceway is not advisable for corrosive environment and commercial garages because they will sometimes break, no? Because for example, if it is corrosive, it will cause rust. And if it is under garages, so we have the load of the vehicles, no? It might cause the underfloor or the cellular floor raceway to break, thereby exposing the conductors to damage and deterioration. Okay, cellular metal floor raceway is defined in Article 3.74.1.2 as the hollow space of cellular metal floor together with suitable fittings that may be approved as enclosure for electric conductors. So it has the same parts as a cellular concrete floor raceway. So it has a header and a cell, and also this raceway cannot be used for corrosive environment and commercial garages. Okay, so this is an example or a view of a cellular metal floor raceway, no? So this is the one, no? So we have here the metal channels and these are the conductors. And this is an appearance of a cellular concrete floor raceway. So we have here the cells here, and these are the precast, no? Precast concrete, no? Okay? Okay, so I believe that will be all for this video. I hope you understand something, and as always, enjoy learning.